Hello students, this is the last session of French classical menu. Previously we have discussed various courses of French classical menu, right from Odo, Potage, of Poisson, Entree, then we had Sorbet, next was Relevé, Roti, and now we are coming to Legumes. And legumes to beverages. So these are the courses which we are going to cover in today's session. And previously, as I spoke about, we have done the courses of entree, relevé, and roti. So legume is a course which is made for vegetarian people, and the dishes in this particular course most of the time are vegetarian preparations, and any kind of vegetable preparation can be served in this particular course. Now, there is a catch in this, that when meat courses are being served before legumes, like relevé and roti, so legume courses becomes an accompaniment to relevé and roti. So potato preparations and green vegetable preparations act as an accompaniment to the relevé and roti. But if the guest is vegetarian, legume itself becomes a main course. And the dishes like artichoke, asparagus, and corn on the cob, okay, with various sauces like hollandaise and mayonnaise and beurre fondue can be served. So these dishes act as a main course dish for a vegetarian guest. The cover for this particular course is small knife, small fork, and half plate. Some other examples of this particular course are purée de pommes, purée pomme sauté, pomme frites, pomme au four, champignon grillé. Champignon is a French word for mushrooms. Chou-fleur mornay, and then we have haricot wort au beurre. So these are the dishes which can be served. On the image on the top, you can see that pomme purée is there. And the bottom image is of chou-fleur mornay. Chou-fleur mornay is your cauliflower, which is cooked with cheese and baked. So these are the preparations which can be served in a legume course. Next we have entremets. And entremets is a course which is known as sweet course. So all the types of sweet preparations can be served in this particular course. So it can be classified into two categories. One is general entremets, and the second is ice creams. So in the general entremets, we can say that anything which except ice cream can be served in this particular course, and the cover would be a dessert plate, dessert fork, and a dessert spoon. Some examples are custards, puddings, and gâteaux. Gâteaux are cakes. And the second category, of course, the ice cream. So various styles of ice creams can be served in this particular course, and the cover would be ice cream cup, underliner, or a BNB plate or a quarter plate with a doily, and ice cream spoon. Some examples are tutti frutti, chocolate fudge, and other ice creams can also be served. Some classical examples of entremets course are crepe Suzette, which is a pancake in a rich fresh orange juice, and which is flambéed with brandy. Then ananas flambé, peach melba, and bombays. So in the image you can see a crepe Suzette being served over here. Now the guest has taken a sweet course. The tongue is coated with the sweetness. We need to break the tongue over here. So for that, some preparation which are a little salty and sweet, which are savory preparations, that can be served. And the savory course can be classified into two categories. So one is the meat savory, and the second one is fish savory. So preparations of kidney, liver, and mutton and chickens are served in the meat savory, and the cover is a small fork, a small knife, and a half plate. And in the fish savory, various styles of fish preparations can be served, and the cover would be fish knife, fish fork, and a half plate. So these dishes are served in a savory course. In the image, you can see angels on horseback on the left side. So these are being served in the savory. The course with the savory is fromages are also served. So what happened actually, in the 17 course menu, savory is a separate course and fromage is a separate course. But when it is reduced to a 13 course menu, both the courses have been combined. So either savory is to be served or fromage is to be served. Fromage basically means cheese. So various styles of cheese can be served, like cheddar, Adam, brie, demoiselle, ricotta, and they can be served in this form, like a cheese platter. So assorted cheese are being placed on a platter with various accompaniments over here, and they can be served to the guest. And the last course of French classical menu is desserts, and desserts over here includes all the styles of fresh fruits and dry fruits, and they are served with caster sugar and sometimes salt if it is required for a particular fruit, and they are served in a fruit basket or on a platter on which fruits are being arranged. The cover for this particular course is half plate, fruit knife and fruit fork. Fruit knife and fruit fork are also known as desert knife and desert fork. Essential accompaniment is sugar dredger with caster sugar. This is how fresh fruits can be served. The fruits which are ordered by guests can be put on a platter, nicely decorated, and then they can be served. Next course is beverages. So as I said, the dessert is the last course. Beverages is a course which is not included in the French classical menu because it's a compulsory course at the end of meal. So whether we are serving a 3-course menu or a 4-course menu or a 5-course menu, beverages will always remain the last course, which is to be not counted in the menu. So if we are serving a 3-course menu, the 4th course becomes beverages. So if we are serving a 6-course menu, the 7th course automatically becomes beverages. So in the beverages, we can serve all the types of tea and all the types of coffees. Thank you so much. This is the end of French classical menu series, and we'll come up with a new series in next video. Thank you.